I'm sorry. I don't know where the truck is. I wish I did.
What happened, Miller? Was it stolen?
No, not exactly. A fella comes in here quite a bit. His name's Paul. He's a good customer. He borrowed the truck from me last night. Said he'd only be gone an hour, and I haven't seen him since.
What happened to your brother is no disgrace, Miss Fisher. It's fairly common. One out of every four persons has some sort of nervous or mental illness during his life. Actually, one out of every 10 is ever hospitalized for it.
But he is insane, isn't he?
That's illegal, not a medical term.
This is my friend, Ken McLaughlin. Stud has that big ranch just over the hill. How do you do, Mr. Wallace? How come you're not plowing? Where's Judy?
Buried them all through plowing, Teddy. Judy's dead. I just buried him.
Dead? What happened?
I went to the house to get something to eat. I heard a shot. When I came out, I found her lying in her traces.
Get on your feet.
Jenkins, it's enough of that foolishness. Get on your feet.
Your mouth. You hear me? Watch it. Get back inside.
I was.
And see, I guess it must have slipped my mind.
I mean, I want you to. Couldn't you get somebody else to take care of your client?
Well, it isn't business, I don't think. It's a friend of Johnny Peters. He's in town for a few days. He called me this morning, so I suggested we have lunch. Oh, darling, I couldn't let Johnny down. He's the best friend a guy ever had. Why, when we get married, Johnny will be right there beside me, holding me up.
Well, I suppose I can't offend Johnny unless I want you falling down at the wedding.
There's a conversation in here segregated to him and the fry cook. I mean, this here is quite an honor. Just talking to somebody who's going to be a movie star. You know, Fern, we ought to get his autograph now while it's still cheap.
I never said I was going to be a movie star. He asked me if I wanted to be one, and I said, sure, why not? Oh, I still say why not.
Oh, is that what you said? Well, I'll tell you why not. You know where to get the movie stars? New York, that's where. Out of them big Broadway plays or some TV shows like Ed Sullivan. I mean, they got to be somebody in the first place. They just don't make no movie star out of somebody coming off the streets. Even if they are pretty, which I got to admit you are pretty.
Listen, I never said I was going to be one. I never even said I'm going to Hollywood.
But I just bet you are.
Well, all right, I am. And I'll tell you something else. I've been in a play. And I've also been on TV, too, in a commercial.
Well, shut my big fat mouth. A commercial? What kind?
It was soap.
Soap? What was you doing? Taking a bubble bath?
I was taking a shower.
Taking a shower. Oh, brother. Taking a shower.
Well, hi, Stump.
Rafe.
Everything, Wolf, like I said?
No hitches yet?
Well, there won't be. Stump, I'd like you to meet my son, Webb.
Son? I never thought you used anybody you knew.
Well, I didn't know Webb until this week. He's all right, though. Tell me, did Dobie get out here all right with that kid?
Half hour ago.
That Kingsley probably...
Don't let him look through you, lady. He's a very important man. The McKenzie and the United States. Very few people in Mexico are our country near your journey. I bought a very important official.
Bought, senor?
Bought. The route you traveled cost me several hundred dollars. Well worth it.
You must realize you are getting involved in an international situation.
It's the other way around. You got yourself involved in a local mess with me and a tough colonel.
You're dealing with Colonel McKenzie means nothing to me. My mission is vital.
What can I do for you?
Well, not much, to tell the truth. I was in the neighborhood, so I thought I'd drop by. See how you were doing with all that gelatin you bought the other day.
Wait a minute, all that 10 pounds?
10? I thought it was 70.
Oh, just 10.
It says 70 here.
Well, I just signed for 10. I'm very careful about these things.
Well, you bought the gelatin. And you know the difference between 10 pounds and 70.
I just signed.
Send a detail to bury.
Sir? Ain't nobody gonna bury the captain but me, sir. After that, I'll be your prisoner.
Saves us the trouble burying him.
So brave soldier came back under fire to bury his company commander. I won't have him insulted or laughed at. Who are you, soldier?
Service. I don't know. I'm sorry. All I got a man get back away, and it's yours. state would like to have a hand like you. Maybe pay you more than Eldridge.
You're getting timid, Heber.
I got a family. I was lying to you. Heber Fallon is dead. I'm a farmer. Don't even own a handgun anymore. How about it, Frank?
Well, I hired out to run you off of the other two. Took the old man's money. That's what I'll do.
Heber. Oh, if you're wondering about these Indian braves, no, I'm not a half-breed. I used to be a scalp hunter. And I thought it was only fair to give the Redskins as much chance to lift my hair as they gave me.
What is a scalp hunter?
A man who's paid a bounty to bring in the scalps of Indians. A professional murderer. Mighty harsh words from a stranger, Doc.
I've been making my arrangements for a week now.
Green girls?
So what?
Young girls don't stay loyal, Meg.
You want to walk in my shoes too, Goldie? You get the girls?
We're all talking from the boss's shoes. He says to remind you what this very house used to be like when Mrs. B ran it. How her girls would stay with her through thick and thin. She used to have to pension them off to get them out.
You got to know how to treat girls, Meg.
Even suppose Ness croaks tomorrow. You still got that.
Who are you? What do you want? You're one of the Richies, aren't you?
Yes, ma'am. I'm done with looking. Keeping company with Shell Davis is one thing. Holding hand with a saddle tramp is something else.
Get out of here.
What are you doing?
I'm not up here to take care of Mike Don. Now, you made a little mistake.
Mike's been holding out. He tapped us in St. Louis.
How about you, Sandy? 250,000 short for the numbers in Chicago.
Give it back. Every cent.
Get him locked.
Listen to me a minute. I said listen to me. You all wanted a regular trial. All right. You got a trial. The fun's over, but the job ain't. I'm here to tell you if Sam Devlin walks out of here a free man, he'll not live to see another day.
He didn't do it, Brad. I swear.
It's like you feel the same as me about Indians.
Yeah? How do you feel?
Like this.
You really hate him, huh?
Yeah, I really hate him. Two of my brothers were with Custer. Sitting Bull massacred all of them at the Battle of the Little Bighorn.
I know how you feel, Taylor. But as long as Big Tim wants to act in the show, we'll just have to get along with it.
It wasn't locked.
They say if anybody can get that killer off, you can.
Well, if that Tanner proves him guilty, I
know he's guilty. My girl's buried out there somewhere.
Nobody knows that way. Nobody knows yet what happened to your daughter.
It was told in court by old man Reese.
What he said in court is not a fact until it's tested by cross-examination.
When you're a hammer at that old man and getting him to sleep like his wife.
If I missed anything that Pop was telling me, Buck, I'd be glad to fill you in.
I don't know what you're talking about. I was sound asleep when you opened that door and it spilled me out on my head.
Yeah? Funny kind of a place to be taking a nap.
It is.
Especially on your day off.
Day off? What is today?
Wednesday.
Holy smoke, I thought it was Tuesday. It's a good thing you told me I'd been on my run to Watsontown.
Yeah.
I'll be doggone. To think I could have spent the whole day on the site. Thanks for waking me up.
What you fooling around with that truck for, stupid? That's no way to get your work done. I'm doing the best I can, Mr. Hendricks. You best better get better. You're going to go back to that hospital. You're just here on trial, you know. I'm better work this truck myself. Yeah, take this rifle up the house and clean it. You been hunting?
Huh?
You been hunting, Mr. Hendricks? Yeah. Not the crows. Old crows.
What kind of favor?
I got my grandson outside there. Now, neither of us is armed, and we mean to cause no trouble. But we'd be obliged to see a prisoner.
Now, you listen to me, Mr. Sonnet. I got a big responsibility here. Your boy, he robbed a ranch outside of town and killed a man and his wife. Shot him
5 years ago. His faith has been his sustenance.
Yeah, that's a lot of poppycock, Skipper. He wants to live as much as the rest of us. Win, lose, or draw. He'll know what the score is when that plane sends help for us.
The law arrests me, then it both prosecutes and defends me. Is that the American way?